Hello everybody, Torello here, and today we're going to look at the US T1E1 heavy tank, which is going to be introduced in the Sky Guardians update. Now, I'm not sure we were particularly supposed to be shown this in the dev server live stream. It is in the dev server itself, and this is a very weird and possibly unfinished tank. Basically, as you can see here, it is supposed to be armed with a 75mm M3 cannon. The very one that is arming the regular M4 Shermans. Now, as far as I'm aware, that was never fitted to the M6 heavy tank. There was no reason to. It was a heavy tank. It was supposed to be armed with the 3-inch gun that the M6A1 already has in game. However, visually, it does look like the 3-inch gun. If you position the tank here, see it just barely goes past that sign in the background. If we compare that to the M6A1. It does seem to protrude about the same distance, maybe a tiny bit more on the M6A1. Whereas, of course, you can see the 75mm gun on the Shermans is far shorter. However, the T1E1 does have the stats for the 75mm gun. As you can see here, it uses the M72 shot, M61, the T45. And these all have very bad stats compared to the 3-inch gun, 78mm at 500 meters with the M72. Look at the M6A1 and yeah, they're all in the hundreds of millimeters. So I don't know if Gaijin's messed up a little bit there, but basically I think that is supposed to be the 3-inch gun. The main big change that it should actually have is that the hull is cast armor. It's about the same thickness as the M6A1, but of course, as many of you who've watched this channel before will already know, cast armor in game has a negative multiplier. Basically, RHA armor, if you've got 100mm at a 90 degree angle, you would need 100mm of penetration to get through it. Whereas cast armor has a 0.94 multiplier. So your 100mm of cast armor, you would only need 94mm of penetration to get through. So this is actually going to be weaker than the regular M6A1, which is weird because it's also been put after the M6A1. I feel like this should go before, really. Although it is the same battle rating, so I suppose it doesn't make that huge a difference. And the other big difference is it has electric transmission. So 6 gears forward, 6 gears back, max speed 23 miles per hour forward and backwards. And also compared to the M6A1, it has a slightly less powerful engine, only 708 horsepower versus 800. And it actually weighs a little bit more, 60.4 tons versus 56.8. But it does seem to have broadly the same speed. Well, it's actually faster technically by about 2 miles per hour, little wonder. Again, maybe to do with that transmission, because of course it has less horsepower, but it is faster while weighing more. So that's kind of unusual. And it seems to retain about the same crew, driver, machine gunner and loader in the hull, and a gunner, loader and commander in the turret. And you may notice it says it's armed with 3 machine guns. It's supposed to mean these two at the front and the one on the roof. But as you'll see in the test drive, there's a bit of a funny glitch. We seem to have an extra crew member and an extra machine gun. Now, first things first, we're just going to show off the electric drive because, as you can see, we are going full speed backwards. It just has the same speed backwards as it does forward, which is very welcome. This would be very good for peeking around corners, ambush situations and such like that. You may also notice the machine gun at the bottom left is going a bit crazy, which we're going to show that off in a second because it does provide some rather interesting effects. So if we just drive to the starting position again and aim to the right and fire the machine gun, and you can just see bullets are spraying everywhere. Sometimes they do come down from the sky, sometimes they come from below. It does kind of look like you have called in a orbital strike or God's wrath at times. Like, bullets are just pinging everywhere, all around us. It's, I assume it's just this front machine gun is glitched and is just firing through the tank, or it's not positioned in the tank. I've definitely seen times where the machine gun is not rotating in the tank on the bottom left, but far off in the distance. And we're just going to show off the 75mm gun quick. Or what is supposed to be a 75mm gun. And it does perform a bit weird at times. It doesn't always consistently penetrate the Panzer II, which tells me this is definitely not the 76mm gun. It must be intended to be the 76mm gun if I fire. I don't know. That definitely looks like the 3-inch gun. That is definitely not meant to be a 75mm gun. I've also sometimes noticed the reticle seems a bit off-center, but that may be for the coaxial gun, the 37mm on the left there. And also, I don't know if it's because it's unfinished or because it's using cast armor, but it looks very, well, unfinished. Like, it's sort of not proper metal. It looks kind of plasticine-y or plastic. And also, the driver's position is also not finished properly because, yeah, I'm sideways. I'm fairly sure that drivers were not supposed to be in their tanks sideways. it's kind of weird some of the things they do finish and don't finish. Anyway, that's been the T1E1. I think this will be a pretty good tank. I wasn't really expecting this to be added in, and, well, I don't think many people were. I think some were maybe expecting the 90mm variant to be added. But, yeah, it'll be another cool American tank, although I don't think it's going to add too much to the game. But, again, sometimes you don't need massive game-changing tanks to be added. Sometimes just a regular, usual tank is all that's needed sometimes. Anyway, that's been the T1E1. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video. I've been Tyranno, and I'll see you next time.